New details tonight about David Camm's final months in custody. He spent them behind bars in Boone County, Indiana. But that all came to an end yesterday when a jury found him not guilty of his family's murders. WLKY's Marissa Alter has more from Lebanon.
It is a much quieter and calmer day here at the Boone County Courthouse now that David Camm's trial has ended, and things in Lebanon are getting back to normal.
David Camm's time in Boone County began in the summer. He walked out Thursday to bitter temperatures, ending a carefully choreographed stay.
We brought Mr. Camm back here to the sheriff's office for out processing, and we had a plan for a guilty verdict, a not guilty verdict, and a hung jury verdict. So once we found out that it was not guilty, we notified our staff here so we could begin out processing prior to his arrival.
Boone County Sheriff Ken Campbell has spent the past year working with his Floyd County counterpart to plot out everything he could with Camm's trial.
This was a major undertaking, and from our perspective, we think things went very smoothly. We did everything we could to try to keep our costs down. Even though we were billing Floyd County, I treated it as just as if the bill was crossing my desk.
Camm had no issues while housed at the local jail.
I had a conversation with him when he first came in that we treat people the way we like to be treated, and he was an absolute gentleman throughout.
Once they wrapped up the paperwork Thursday, sheriff's deputies released Camm to his family.
We met them at a local truck stop. Mr. Camm was very polite, very respectful, very quiet. Probably overwhelmed by it all, and I wished him well and wished him the best to get on with his life, and I said, from a gray-haired old policeman, life's too short to be bitter about things, and it's time to look forward now.
And Camm can do that thanks to the decision by this jury of 8 women and 4 men. At the moment, they wish to remain anonymous. The jury foreman's name was redacted from the verdict forms. In Lebanon, I'm Marissa Alter, WLKY News.
All right, Marissa. And despite the verdict, David Camm's fight in court is not over. The parents of Kim Camm have filed 2 civil lawsuits to prevent him from collecting life insurance and investment funds stemming from his family's deaths. Well, the media got a close-up look at all the evidence in the Camm case this morning. Both sides entered roughly 500 exhibits during the 9-week trial. Jurors had access to nearly all of it during the 10-hour deliberations. They specifically asked to see the gray sweatshirt that Camm was wearing the night of his family's murders. It's full of holes from all the testing performed over the years. The exhibits will be returned to the evidence locker for storage. State statute says that the items must be saved for at least 50 years. We have extensive coverage of the David Camm trial online for you. Just visit WLKY.com. We have a slideshow of the evidence jurors saw in court, as well as reaction to the verdict from attorneys and the families involved. And here are the thoughts of Richard Schlesinger, the 48 Hours correspondent who covered the case from the beginning for CBS News. It's all there on our homepage.